Right? In the last class, I had explained geometrically position of Z1 plus Z2, Z1 into Z2, Z1 by Z2, Z1 by Z1 minus Z2, etc. Now I am going to explain problems related to the last concept. See, first one. This is the previous main problem. If Z1 minus Z3 by Z2 minus Z3 equal to 1 minus I2 3 by 2, then the triangle formed by the Z1 comma Z2 comma Z3 is arc means equilateral triangle, right angle triangle, isosceles triangle, right angle and isosceles triangle. Okay. See, first I am applying modulus on both sides. Modulus of Z1 minus Z3 by Z2 minus Z3 equal to modulus of A plus IB from the root of A square plus B square. So root of 1 by 4 plus root 3 by 2 whole square equal to 1. So that means modulus of Z1 minus Z3 equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z3. Okay? Clearly from this, LHS represents the distance between the points Z1 comma Z3. Similarly, distance between the points Z2 comma Z3. So distance between Z1 comma Z3 and Z2 comma Z3 are same. So two sides are equal. Okay? Now I am applying argument on both sides to give in one. Okay. Argument of Z1 minus Z3 by Z2 minus Z3 equal to argument of 1 minus I root 3 by 2. Okay. Argument of the complex number formula, tan inverse of y by x. So root 3 by 2 by 1 by 2 is root 3. Plus minus means fourth quadrant. Therefore, tan inverse of root 3 is pi by 3. Minus no problem. That one means anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction. Numerically angle is 60 degrees. Numerical angle is 60 degrees. What about this meaning? Argument of Z1 minus Z3 by Z2 minus Z3 equal to theta means that theta is angle subtended by the line segment joining Z1 comma Z2 at the point Z3 because Z3 is common. In both already I had explained in last class. Here Z3 common. Z3 common means that 60 is angle at Z3. So this is 60. Okay. Two sides are in a triangle, two sides are equal means opposite angles are also equal. So one is angle 60, other two angles are equal means so other two are also clearly 60, 60. Therefore, clearly given vertexes Z1, Z2, Z3 form an equilateral triangle. So if you have an idea about this concept without written work, without written work, you can find answer. Okay. See, second problem. If mod Z equal to 3, then area of the triangle formed by Z, omega Z, Z plus omega Z. So already I had proved the formula for this. Area of the triangle formed by Z, omega Z, Z plus omega Z is root 3 by 4 into mod Z square, where mod Z is 3. So by such to get it for you. Next. Third one, if Z1 comma Z2 are the roots of quadratic equation, square plus az plus b equal to 0. And origin comma z1 comma z2 are vertices of an equator triangle. Then, so options relations between the numbers A and B. Okay. So see, given that z1 comma z2 are vertices of roots of this quadratic equation, and moreover given that origin z1 z2 are vertices of an equator triangle. So one standard result by heart change. If z1, z2, z3 are vertices of an equilateral triangle, then formula z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square equal to z1, z2 plus z2, z3 plus z3, z1. Okay. But here in the place of z3 there is origin. Therefore, z3 square, z3 is origin. Therefore, in the place of z3 square, origin 0 into z2, 0, 0 into z1, 0. So, origin z1, z2 are vertices of an equilateral triangle, then z1 square plus z2 square equal to z1, z2. Again, this can be expressed as z1 plus z2 whole square minus 2 z1, z2 equal to z1, z2. Why we are writing like this? Given that z1, z2 are roots of this one means we can find sum of the roots and product of the roots. Okay? Sum of the roots is clearly minus a. So minus a whole square. A square minus 2 into product of the roots b equal to b. Therefore, answer a square equal to 3b. So many problems can create the concept, the standard result, the condition for z1, z2, z3 are vertices of an equator triangle. So by heart, that one. Next problem also related to the same concept. See, fourth one. If z1, comma z2, comma z3 are vertices of an equator triangle and z0 is circumcenter of the triangle, then z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square equal to options in terms of z0. Options in terms of z0. See, given z1, z2, z3 are vertices of an equator triangle, and moreover given that z0 is circumcenter. In an equator triangle, circumcenter coincides with the centroid. So that is also centroid. Therefore, z0 equal to z1 plus z2 plus z3 by 3. Centroid formula. Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by 3. Now, condition for Z1, Z2, Z3 are vertices of an equilateral triangle. Z1 square plus Z2 square plus Z3 square equal to Z1, Z2 plus Z2, Z3 plus Z3, Z1. Now, by cross multiplication and squaring on both sides, 9 z0 square equal to z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square plus 2 times of z1, z2 plus z2, z3 plus z3, z1 can be replaced with z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square from this result. So 2 times of z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square, because required z1 square plus z2 square plus z3 square. So finally, RHS is 3 times of required on both sides by cancelling 3. Required is 3 into z0 square. one equal to 3 plus 2y, z2 equal to 7 minus y, and argument of z minus z1y, z minus z2 equal to 5 by 2. Then area of the triangle formed by z, z1 and z2 is also 6. Then number of positions of z. Number of positions of z. Already we had seen this the concept related to this one, the first year locus problem, not locus problem, straight lines. Straight lines were chosen already, Satish Babu chosen already. See, concept related to this one. First, I am explaining. A and B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the same plane, such that angle APB equal to 90 degrees. APB equal to 90 degrees. Then number of positions of P. Working rule. Draw the circle with AB as a diameter. Draw the circle with AB bar as a diameter of the circle. Okay. Suppose radius of the circle R equal to height of the triangle ABB. Height of the triangle ABB. Then position of P, two places, here and here. R equal to H. In these two positions, R equal to H. So in this case, number of positions of P is 2. Next, suppose R greater than H, then there exists 4 positions here. Suppose H is 2, H is 2, R is 3. So at the height of 2, there exists 4 positions. Height 2, height 2, height 2, height 2. There exists 4 positions. So in this case, number of positions of P is 4. Condition R greater than H. Next, H greater than R. AB diameter of the circle. H greater than R means P outside the circle. Then only possible. P outside the circle. In this case, H greater than R, P outside the circle, but which is contradiction? Because angle ABB equal to 90 means P must and should lie at the circle. Because angle in a semicircle 90. So in this case not possible, contradiction. Therefore in this case number of positions of P is 0. So this is concept. We put the first year already circles, second year circles, first year locus, straight lines. So for this, what we do? We have to find radius of the circle R and height of the triangle ABB. First, I am drawing the circle with ends z1, z2, 3, 2, 7, minus 1. And area of the triangle. So, argument of z minus z1 by z minus z2 equal to y by 2 means that one means this one z common. Z common means that angle is 90 is angle at z. Means that 90 degrees is angle subtended by the line segment joining z1, z2 at z. Okay, now? Z1, z2 are ends of the circle. And area of the triangle. Yes. Area of the triangle of base into height equal to 6. So, half base is the distance between the two points. AB. 7 minus 3. minus 1, minus 2, 9, so 5. H equal to 6. Therefore, H equal to 12 by 5 means 2.4. Okay. Now, radius. Radius of the circle means diameter by 2 and 5 by 2. E is 2.5. Therefore, R greater than H. R greater than H means this diagram. So, number of equations of E is 4. Next problem, sixth one. If Z1, Z2, Z3 are vertexes of equilateral triangle, then argument of Z2 plus Z3 minus 2Z1 by Z3 minus Z2 is. Okay. So given that Z1, Z2, Z3 are vertices of an equilateral triangle. Z1, Z2, Z3. Small change. Divide the numerator and denominator with 2. Z2 plus Z3 by 2 minus Z1 by Z3 minus Z2. So in the last class I had explained what is the meaning of argument of Z1 minus Z2 by Z3 minus Z4 equal to theta. Meaning of this one is theta is angle between the two lines, one line passing through Z1, Z2. Okay. Other line passing through Z3, Z4. This is angle theta. Same. So required is angle between the line passing through this point and that point and this point and that point. Clearly this is midpoint of line segment joining Z2, Z3. Midpoint. Now angle is angle between the lines Z1 and 2 midpoint, this one, and Z2 and Z3. So angle between the median and the third side is required. Okay. In an equilateral triangle, median coincide with the altitude. This one altitude means angle 90. B is midpoint, actually median. In an equilateral triangle, median coincide with the altitude, so angle is 90. So required by way. Seventh one, if Z1, Z2, Z3 are the vertices of triangle having angles 90 degrees, 30 degrees and 60 degrees, then, so options, advanced problem, more than one options. Right angle triangle, angle at Z1 is 90, at Z2, 30, at Z3, 60, this is Z2, this is Z3. So we can observe from this data, so we can apply Pauli rotation at Z1 and also Z2 and also Z3. After that by observing the options, get more than two options. Okay. First I am applying First, see the ratio of sides of triangle when angle is 90, 30 and 60 from the sine rule. First, the properties of triangles. Sine rule, A by sine A equal to B by sine B equal to C by sine C. So, A by triangle A, sine A 90 equal to B by sine B, sine 30, 1 by 2. C by sine C, sine 60, root 3 by 2. Okay. In denominator, into 2, into 2, into 2. So, A by 2 equal to B by 1 equal to C by 2. So, ratio of A, B, C. A means, so this is angle A, this is angle B, this is angle C. Side opposite to A is denoted by A, side opposite to B is denoted by B, side opposite to C is denoted by C. So, 2 is 2, 1 is 2, root 3. Okay. Now, I am applying pony rotation at 60 degrees. So, do you remember how to apply pony rotation? Draw the anti-clockwise direction and the lateral part. Anti-clockwise direction. Arrow mark on this one. Arrow mark on this one. Z2 minus Z3 by Z1 minus Z3 equal to modulus of Z1 into e power I 60 degrees minus pi by 2. So from this now, Z2 minus Z3 equal to what is modulus of Z2 minus Z3 by Z1 minus Z3? Z2 minus Z3 means the distance between Z2 and Z3 and then 2 by Z1 minus Z3 and then B, 2 by 1. So this value is 2. Okay. 2 into e power I by e power I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. So cos pi by 3, 1 by 2 plus I sin pi by 3, root 3 by 2 into Z1 minus Z3. Leave it. 2 cancel. Now see the options. If you have the changes, the change. That will be the option. One of the options. Similarly, we can apply pony rotation to 90 degrees and 30 degrees. There are three results. Then see the options. Get answer. Two are more than two options. Next problem. Point of intersection of argument of z minus 3i equal to 3 pi by 4 argument of z minus 3i equal to 3 pi by 4 and argument of 2z plus 1 minus 2y equal to pi by 4 is actually first these two represents two straight lines. By solving those two straight lines, get point of intersection theoretically, but that one correct avachu, wrong avachu, andike theoretically cheyagaledu. So already I had explained geometrically what is the meaning of argument of z minus z1 equal to theta. Because I explained less than correctly. Z1 is a fixed point, z is a variable point, such that argument of z minus z1 equal to theta, geometrical meaning, graph. First, locate the point to z1. Okay? That one is the first coordinate, or second coordinate, or third coordinate, or fourth coordinate, or lie on x axis, or lie on y axis. Okay? Now see the angle. Now imagine at that point three coordinates are same, and imagine that at that point x axis and y axis. Okay? Now theta. Theta is in the first coordinate, then locus of that one, like this, way, without vertex. Okay? If theta lies between 90 and 180, then locus of that one. theta lies between minus 90 and 0, fourth quadrant. Theta lies between minus pi and minus pi by 2, then third quadrant. Okay. So I am drawing graph of the first one, x-axis, y-axis. 3i means 0, 3, lies on positive y-axis. Angle 3 pi by 4 means 4th quadrant. Angle is 2 pi by 4, is that from concept? 0 to 90, clear. 90 to 180, clear. Minus 180 to minus 90, here. Minus 90 to 0. Okay. 3 pi by 4 means the second quadrant. So graph of this one is like this. Right. Next, first divide into 2. Z 1 by 2 minus 1. So this can be expressed as Z minus of minus 1 by 2 plus. Minus 1, 3, 0, 3. Minus 1 by 2, 1 belongs to 4th quadrant. Minus 1 by 2, 1 equals 2. Okay, now. Angle pi by 4 means first quadrant. First quadrant and 11. See, clearly, no, the even intersection comes here. So, point of intersection of the given two lines is does not exist. So, one of the options does not exist. अरे ये क्रिएट के लिए समझो z इक्वल x plus y by this one tan inverse of this one and minus 1 tan inverse of this one and 1 this one is the point where this point of intersection but that is wrong and one of the options is the compulsory so remember the compulsory ka graph draw diya hai These are problems related to the last concept. Next concept, standard loci. Standard loci. After that, problems related to standard loci. So, all of you know standard loci, but small difference already we have seen the standard loci in coordinate geometry. So, the complex numbers are all on the check this. So, I am explaining it comparatively geometry and complex numbers. Okay. See, first two lines. First lines. Let A and B are two fixed points. A and B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the plane such that PA equal to PB. Then what about the locus of P? So in this case, locus of P is perpendicular bisector of the line segment joining A and B. All of you know that one. So we call it school which also A and B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the same way such that P equal to P. Then locus of P is perpendicular bisector of line segment joining A and B. Because from any point on this line, distances are same. Okay. Then the complex numbers arise there. Same. See. Z1, Z2 are two fixed points. Z is a variable point such that modulus of Z minus Z1 equal to modulus of Z minus Z2. This is distance between Z and Z1. Distance between Z and Z2. Distance between P and B. Distance between P and B. So, this small one is going to be done. So, Z1, Z2 are two fixed points, Z is a variable point such that satisfies this one. Then, locus of Z is a perpendicular bisector of a line segment to joining Z1, Z2. Okay. applications are for this one. Suppose A is A comma 0, B is minus A comma 0, P is a variable point such that PA equal to PB. What is the locus of P? Clearly, locus of P is perpendicular bisector of line segment joining these two points, means that is clearly y-axis. Clearly, perpendicular bisector of line segment joining these two points is y-axis. Because y-axis is perpendicular to x-axis and these two points are at equidistant from y-axis. Okay. So, similar to that one in complex number, z1 is A, z2 is minus A, such that modulus of z minus z1 equal to modulus of z minus z2, then locus of z is y-axis. Okay. Suppose A is 0 comma A, B is 0 comma minus A, and P equal to PB. Then locus of P is x-axis, 0 comma A lies on positive x-axis, 0 comma minus A lies on negative x-axis. Clearly, perpendicular bisector of line segment joining these two points is x-axis. In complex numbers, z1 is ai, ai means the point 0 comma a, a means the point a comma 0. Similarly, z2 is minus ai, such that modulus of z minus z1 equal to modulus of z minus z2, then locus of z is clearly x-axis. So, this is about two lines, standard okay. Next, circles. In circles, so many cases, already you have seen all in the lesson circles. Next one of the standard okay. Circles. Okay. C is a fixed point, P is a variable point, such that CP equal to R, then locus of P is a circle. Locus of P is a circle. So the C is the center of the circle. That R is the equidistant to R is the radius of the circle. Same. Z1 is a fixed point. Z is a variable point such that modulus of Z minus Z1 equal to R. Then locus of Z is a circle with the center Z1 and radius to R. So, that fixed point, okay, clear. Suppose, center of the circle is origin. Center of the circle is origin. Then this one becomes mod z equal to r. Mod z means modulus of z minus 2. OE is origin. So, this one represents the circle with the center origin and radius r. One more case in the circles, standard okay. Right. See, A and B are two fixed points. A and B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the same plane such that P squared plus PB squared equal to AB square, then also locus of P is a circle because this is Pythagoras theorem, right angle triangle property. P square plus PB square equal to AB square means angle at P is 90. So converse, angle in a semicircle 90, converse is also true. So from that, the similar concept related to that one in the complex number. Z1, Z2 are two fixed points. Z is a variable point such that modulus of Z minus Z1 whole square plus modulus of Z minus Z2 whole square equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2 whole square. See, Z is P, Z1 is A. Modulus of Z minus Z1 whole square means P A square. This one means P B square. This one represents the distance between the two points. So Z1 comma Z2 means A B square. Okay. So then locus of Z is a circle with ends of the diameter Z1 comma Z2. In this case, ends of the diameter of that locus circle are Z1 comma Z2. Next. Next case is circles in geometry. In geometry, see, A, B are two fixed points. A, B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the same plane such that PA by PB equal to K, which is not equal to 1, then locus of P is also circular. అది ఆల్రెడీ లోకస్ ఫస్ట్ లోకస్ లెసన్ లో చెప్పుకున్నాం, సర్క్యూస్ లెసన్ లో కూడా చెప్పుకున్నాం. కే నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1 మీన్స్ దట్ వన్ లెస్ దాన్ 1 ఆర్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ 1. సీ హౌ టు లోకస్ ఆఫ్ పి ఇస్ ఎ సర్కిల్ వెన్ పి ఏ బై పి బి ఇస్ కే విచ్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1. Suppose k greater than 1, two cases, k greater than 1. When k greater than 1, pa greater than pb. Pa greater than pb. Pa, pb. When k greater than 1, pa greater than pb. Then locus of p is in circle. Where also the circle? Draw the internal angle bisector. And similarly, draw the external angle bisector. Angle bisectors are always perpendicular. Already must be aware of side length of this. Okay, na? Suppose this is x, this is y. Now xy subtends the right angle at P. XY subtends right angle at P. So xy subtends right angle at P means the locus of P is a circle into xy as a diameter. That's locus of P is a circle. So k greater than 1. When k greater than 1, what are the coefficients of A and B with respect to the circle? A outside the circle, but B inside the circle. K less than 1 means PA less than P. PA small 1, PB big 1. PA B. Draw the internal angle bisector. External angle bisector. Angle between them always 90. Suppose this is x, this is y. XY subtends right angle at P means locus of P is a circle with XY as a ends of the diameter of the circle. In this case, what about the coefficients of A and B? A inside the circle, but B outside the circle. So this is locus of P when PA by PB equal to K, which is not equal to 1, means greater than 1 or less than 1. Similarly, concept in complex numbers. Z1, Z2 are two fixed points. Z is a variable point in the same plane such that modulus of Z minus Z1 by modulus of Z minus Z2 equal to K, which is not equal to 1, then locus of P, Z is a circle. Here are the two same. Just in the place of A, Z1, in the place of B, Z2, in the place of B, Z2, which is 1. same. K greater than 1, Z1 outside the circle, Z2 inside the circle. K less than 1, Z1 inside the circle, Z2 outside the circle. Next case is similar, circles, triangle, okay? So all of you know that one. You can see that one in school. That is, see, angle, yes, sorry, first, A and D are two fixed points in the plane, such that P is a variable point in the same plane, and angle ABB equal to theta, then locus of P is a part of the circle, arc of the circle, not complete circle, arc of the circle. In that again two cases, if theta is acute, then locus of P is a major arc of the circle. If theta is obtuse, then in that case locus of P is a minor arc of the circle, minor arc of the circle. In school, in any circle, in any circle, any part subtends equal angles of the circumference of the circle. This is only gada. The angles are the same. Theta, 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 and so on. So locus of angle ABB theta means locus of B is only equal to circumference. Or major arc of the circle when theta is acute. Obtuse and bendy. Which the points A and B are two fixed points circle on the plane. If theta is acute, then locus of A is major arc of the circle. E part of the If theta is obtuse, then locus of P is major arc of the circle. Minor arc of the circle. And E part of the okay? Now similar statement in the complex number Z1, Z2 are two fixed points. Z is a variable point in the same plane such that argument of Z minus Z1 by Z minus Z2 equal to theta, then locus of Z is a circle. Sorry, arc of the circle. What is the meaning of this one? Here Z common. Z common means that theta is angle subtended by the line segment joining Z1, Z2 and Z. Same, if theta is acute, locus of Z is a major arc. If theta is obtuse, then locus of Z is minor arc of the circle. If theta is 90, then complete circle. If theta is 90, that one means angle in a semicircle 90. Converse is also true, 90 degrees, then locus of, in that case, if theta is 90, in that case, locus of Z is a circle with Z1, Z2 are ends of the diameter of the circle. So, these are four cases of circle was completed. Next, conic section, particularly ellipse and diameter. Locus. Locus to locus in the reverse thing. Javina in the ellipse hyperbola complete. See, A and B are two fixed points. A and B are two fixed points. P is a variable point in the same plane such that PA plus PB equal to AB and PA plus PB greater than AB. Next. PA plus PB less than AB. In this case, PA plus PB equal to AB, then position of P between AB. So that means this one implies locus of P is a line segment. In this case, locus of P is ellipse. In this case, not possible for any positions of A and B is line segment. Okay. What about these two? These two are foci of four ellipse. S and S dash. All of them are result to S3 plus so S dash B equal to 2A. Where S and S dash are foci of ellipse. So B is any point on the ellipse. Okay. So the complex numbers are Z1, Z2 are two fixed points. So Z is a variable point in the same plane. PA. Akada. Akada PA means here modulus of Z minus Z1 plus PB means modulus of Z minus Z2. AB means modulus of Z1 minus Z2. So if Z satisfies this condition, then locus of Z is a line segment. If this is greater than AB, then locus of Z is ellipse. If this is less than that one, then locus of Z is empty set, not positive. So this is about ellipse. Next. Same, A and B are two fixed points, B is a variable point in the same plane such that modulus of A minus BB equal to AB. Modulus of A minus BB less than AB. Modulus of A minus BB greater than AB. In this case, locus of B is a union of two rays. A and B are two fixed points. PA minus PB equal to AB, then cohesion of B. PB minus PA equal to AB, then cohesion of B. Now, modulus of PA minus PB means locus of P is union of these two rays. P does not lie between A and B. This way and this way. So, modulus of PA minus PB equal to AB, then locus of P is union of two rays. Already first locus to explanation, hyperbolic explanation, this is third time, and the green color. Right. For this, locus of P is hyperbolic. Locus of P is hyperbola. What about A and B? A and B are foci of hyperbola. In this case not possible. So for this locus of P is empty set. Now thus related concept in complex numbers. Modulus of PA minus PB equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2. So for this locus of Z is union of two rays. If greater less than empty set, greater than less than hyperbola, greater than not possible empty set. In this case Z1 comma Z2 are foci of hyperbola. So this is about standard loci of ellipse and hyperbola. First complete. Next, next one of the standard loci. See the meaning of argument of Z equal to theta. Argument of Z equal to theta. Means angle, that first basically that one means angle subtended by the line segment to joining Z and origin with the positive direction of x axis in anti-clockwise direction. So argument of Z equal to theta represents if argument of Z equal to theta, then locus of Z is a ray without vertex. You know what? Origin does not. Z is not equal to origin. Ray. Right? Because it's angle theta, angle theta, angle theta, and so on. Okay. So, what is the similar meaning of argument of Z lies between alpha and beta? Same. Argument of Z equal to alpha means this way, means this angle alpha. Argument of Z equal to beta means if this angle is beta, argument of Z equal to beta represents this way. argument of the attacks between alpha and beta means that is the set of points lies between these two rays. ये मध्यलो ना इतने number of points मत समझते. Next important one, see last one. If mod z equal to r, if mod z equal to r, then locus of z plus 1 by z is ellipse. And formula for equation of that one is x squared by r plus 1 by r whole squared plus y squared by r minus 1 by r whole squared equal to 1. See the proof of that one. Required is locus of z plus 1 by z. So locus of z plus first 2, let z equal to r into cos theta plus I sin theta, polar form of the convex number. Then 1 by z equal to 1 by r into cos theta plus I sin theta. By rationalize the denominator, cos minus I sin by cos square plus I square value 1. Therefore, z plus 1 by z equal to r into cos plus I sin theta plus 1 by r into cos minus I sin theta. Now, locus of this one is required. So, locus of this one is required means working rule. We have assumed that one as x plus I. In the geometry, locus of P means we have to assume P as a P x comma y. So in geometry, x comma y means so here x plus I. So by equating the element imaginary parts on both sides, x equal to cos theta into r plus 1 by r, y equal to sin theta into r minus 1 by r. So from this, cos theta equal to x by r plus 1 by r. From this, sin theta equal to y by r minus 1 by r. Now we can eliminate the theta from these two equations by using identity. Cos y plus sin square equal to 1 implies x square by r plus 1 by r whole square plus y square by r minus 1 by r whole square equal to 1. So this is locus of 2. Z plus 1 by Z when mod Z equal to 1. So this is clearly, this is in the form of X squared by A squared plus Y squared by B squared equal to 1 represents ellipse. I have this one. Problem is based on this one. Just there will be 2 mod S of Z equal to some positive real number. Then what is the locus of Z plus 1 by Z? Just by substitute that R value in this equation, get required locus equation. So, by heart this one. Forget the proof and the logic, etc. And also remember the locus of Z plus 1 by Z is ellipse. Because in some cases, what is locus of Z plus 1 by Z? In some cases, options to straight line, circle, ellipse, parabola like that. So, in that case, clearly answer ellipse. Just to tick this point. So, these are the standard. Okay. In next class, we will discuss problems related to this standard locus. So, here is the class, the standard locus, prepare only. Then, you will feel comfort in next class.